Yes, yesterday we have started, right? What is the version? What is meant by version? What is an edition? How many versions are there? So, just a brief introduction for the extra yesterday's class. Like we have versions from 97 to 2017. So we are having versions like SQL Server 97 to SQL Server 2000, SQL Server 2005, SQL Server 2008, then 8R2, 12, 14, 16. Version is nothing but an advanced copy of a software. So like that. So till 2016 we have a platform till 2016 SQL Server is platform dependent. Only we have to, if we want to install SQL Server 2000, we have to buy Microsoft OS also. So on Microsoft Windows Server only we can able to. Microsoft Windows Server means Microsoft desktop, desktop version or Windows Server. So anything, we can install SQL Server on Windows Server. So from 2017 onwards it became platform independent, like not only on Windows servers, not only on Windows OS, we can also install on Linux OS also. So from SQL Server 2017 onwards that was platform independent. So you can able to you have an idea like what is CTP, RC, RTM. Community technology preview is nothing but a beta version of a software copy, means a test version. It will not directly go to the production. So first of all, if the Microsoft want to introduce any product before going to the licensed version, so it will release the software into the market as community technology preview. Anyone can download this software and they can practice and they can give feedback what are the problems with the software. Then they will rectify all the they will take the feedbacks from the customers, then they'll rectify if any issues are there, then they'll release like released candidate version. So this is also not a licensed version. So after all the feedback from the customers, and if they did all changes, then they released RTM, released to market version. So if the software, this is a paid version, this is a licensed version. So this version will be on production servers, stage servers. So we have four platforms, like test servers, next dev servers, next stage servers, next production server. Production server is the ultimate server, ultimate stage. Stage servers are the pre-final, like pre-production type of platform. So after that, once RTM is released, so every year some updates will be released by the company. Some of the updates will be released to the software by Microsoft. So that is called that update is called as a service pack. So what is a bill number? So bill number means we can able to identify from which version the SQL Server belongs to. The SQL Server belongs to which version, we can able to identify the version of the SQL Server by using this bill number. So here you can able to, where you can see the bill number in the SQL Server. So you can able to see, like in two ways you can able to see the bill number. Once you connect it to the SQL Server, here you can able to see the bill number, like 10.50.6000. And one more way I have told, right? What is the query to see the version of the SQL Server? Query for SQL Server, to find the version of the SQL Server, we can run like select @ version command. Give me a minute, it is just taking time to load. Okay, select new query or control N. If you press control N also, new query window will open, means like a session will open. So what is the query for that? Select @ version, then you can able to find version of a SQL Server. Here you can able to find. So by using these two numbers, this is a, what is this number? This is a bill number. From this number we can, this is a major version and this is a minor version. So this is an actual bill number and this is a revision history. So by using this number, generally we can able to understand from which version the SQL Server belongs to which version. So if it is 11, means it is a SQL Server 2012. So you can able to see here, for 97 the bill number starts with 7.0, for 2000 bill number starts with 8.0, for 2005 bill number starts with 9.0, like go on, it will go 2008 10.0. So parallelly in the program files you will able to find the folders with these numbers. So what this numbers contains, what this folders contains, means some files belongs to the SQL Server software, some DLLs, RLLs, everything you can find in these folders. So this is called instance. This is called as binaries. We can call this folders as a binaries. So we have one more folder is called instance root directory. There you can find files of a databases. So like that, if you can able to see here, right? Here 10.50 means it is showing like 10.50 means which server it is. Without seeing this one, we can able to answer this. Maybe it will belongs to SQL Server 2008 R2. Why? Because for SQL Server 2008 10.0 will be there. For SQL Server 2008 R2 10.50 will be there. So it will belongs to SQL Server 2008 R2. So like this we can able to tell the version of the SQL Server. So yesterday we learned about that version also. So now you can able to understand what is meant by addition. What are free additions? What is the period for the free addition? How many days we can use the free addition? So what is an addition? Addition is nothing but a limited features. See, for example, in express addition, we can't able to use all the features. In enterprise addition, we can able to use all the features. Means express addition is free, right? So it is free for 180 days. So we may not find any features. So here in enterprise addition, it is the most highest addition in the production server. So almost all production servers and stage servers you can find enterprise edition softwares only. These are licensed version. Enterprise edition means it's a licensed version. So you enterprise edition contains all the features. Then we discussed about something like components. What is meant by components? Components means if you install SQL Server, besides of database engine, we can also install like analysis services, reporting services, integration services. What all these services are used for? As we have already discussed that SQL Server is a database software which will store the data, which will retrieve the data, which will process the data. This database engine services will use it to store and retrieve the data. And remaining these three services will be used for analysis, analyzer purpose, to analyze the data, to get the reports from the data, and as well as what is an integration services? Integration services will help to get the data from different database sources like Oracle, DB2, Postgres, MySQL. Like we have different softwares, database softwares in the market. We are interested in SQL Server. Some other company may be interested in Oracle Server. Some other company may be interested in DB2. So if that is the case, if we want to analyze the data from different database sources, then integration services will helpful to get the data from different data sources. Next, so yesterday we have discussed like how to create a virtual machine, how to install Windows OS. Now today we are going to discuss generally how the real time will how the environment will look like. So for example, if you are working in an organization as a DBA, generally how you will you connect to the server. Now today I'll tell you how you will connect to the server. How to connect to the production server or any server. How to connect to the production server. So for that, generally if you log into the to our laptop in the office, we will take the remote connection of the production server. So production servers will be there in somewhere. They will be virtually existed or physically existed. We will connect to the servers by using a remote desktop connection, RDP. We will call it as RDP. By using RDP, we can connect to the office servers. By using RDP. RDP means what is that? RDP means remote desktop connection. Means here, in this case, server will be there. Server means nothing but a computer. Computer will be there somewhere. It may be exist physically or it may be exist virtually, like we have created yesterday, right? Yesterday we have created this server. So I created this server virtually. So there is no physical server. If you see the properties, MS Info 32, how can we find the properties of a system? We can just open run command and just type MS Info 32. You can able to see the properties of the system. Means what is the RAM size? What is the hard disk size? So you can able to see everything here. So earlier while creating the system, I gave like 3 GB RAM. So that's why it is showing 3 GB RAM. I created the server virtually. So this is not a physical server. So at the same time, I gave some hard disk also, like 30 GB capacity I gave. So you can able to see here. Hard disk, C drive, 30 GB, in that almost 14 GB used and 16.4 GB is free. So like that, this is a virtual server. Almost all organization, the servers will be like this only. So depends on the OS. Now I have installed OS 2008 R2. So like SQL Server 2000, like SQL Server versions, Windows servers also having versions. Like basically OS will divide into two categories. One is desktops, which will use it for public purpose, means generally personal use, public will use. And another one is servers. In servers, we have different, like in desktop also we have different versions, right? Enterprise, something like that, Home Basic, Visual Studio, now Windows 7, 97 also, earlier 97 is also there, Windows desktop versions. Then 8.1 came, 8 came, 8.1 came, now 10 is running, right? Windows desktop versions. Like that, Windows servers also having some versions. Like Windows Server 2000, Windows Server 2003, there is no Windows Server 2005, Windows Server 2008, Windows Server 2008 R2, Windows Server 2016. Currently, recently, Windows Server 2016 was released. So we have different versions. So companies generally will go for a new version, or else if the product is already exist, product is nothing but an application. We call product as an application. Generally in the office, in the real time, we will call it as a product. Product is nothing but an application, any application which will be supported by the company. For example, Google. Google supports multiple applications like Gmail. Gmail is a product for us. So Gmail will run an application servers, background database servers also will be there to support the Gmail database. So product is nothing but an application from the company. So the production servers will be there. So how to connect to this production servers virtually? Even though they are physical servers or virtual servers, we will connect to the servers. Once we connected to the servers, we will do our work. Like we will connect to the SQL server, then we will create some, we will do some DBA tasks, like creating a database, taking backup, something DBA task will be there. So we will do those tasks. So how to connect to the server in real time? Generally, if you go to the office, first of all, I am configuring a remote desktop. Okay, first I am configuring to the remote desktop to the virtual machine. So first, where I will go? Go to my computer. Just go to properties of computer, my computer, go to properties, just note it down here. From here onwards, it will be like GUI. You have to note down all the options if you want to practice, otherwise you will forget about the things what I did. So click on remote settings. Before that, I just want to show one thing. Like in the office, if you go to the office, if you log into the office laptop, for connecting production servers virtually, you will just run MSTSC command in run. So MSTSC will pop up this screen like remote desktop connection. You can able to see here, remote desktop connection. So if you provide the IP of a virtual machine, if you provide here, in this case our virtual machine is this one. In this case our virtual machine is this one. I need to connect to this virtual machine remotely. So what I have to do, I need to give the IP address of this machine. How to find out the IP address of this machine? Just open command prompt. Just type open command prompt. Just type ipconfig. So now you can able to see what address you are able to see. IPv4 address is there na? So that is the IP address of the company. You can able to see multiple IP addresses, like IPv6 also you can able to see. But the IPv4 address, by using IPv4 address only we can communicate to the server. So here you can able to see IPv4 address. So remember, by using this IPv4 address, we can able to connect to the server remotely. So now we are connecting server remotely. So don't think that this platform will exist to you. So you will never see this type of virtual platform. This will be under control of data sorry Windows administrators or some other platforms will be there, some other teams will be there to control virtual machines. So don't think that you have direct access to the VM console. We will call it as VM console. What console? Virtual machine console. So you don't have any permissions to see the all servers. So you have only IP address. For example, if production servers are there for any product, if production servers are there, that production server IP address you will be available. So you have to connect to the IP address of the production server. Then while if you once you have entered the IP address, then you can able to directly connect to the server. So here we can check the IP address like 10.0.2.15. So now I just try to connect by using the 10.0.1.1 minute. So if you try to connect, automatically it will throw error, means it is not a proper IP address to connect to the server remotely. So it will take some time, then it will find whether IP address is able to connect or not, then it will throw error. Just give me a minute. It throws an error, like it is not a valid IP address to connect to the server. So now what we have to do, right? So just remember this IP address. Now I will change some settings, then the IP address will also change. So open my computer and click on this remote settings. We have to enable remote settings in the server which we want to connect remotely. So here click on this allow connections, second option. Allow connections from computers running any version remote desktop, less secure. Okay, click on OK. Just note it down anywhere so that you can be able to practice well. So just click on apply. Then click on OK. So now we have enabled remote settings. Remote settings to our server. Now we have to do one more change in the virtual machine console. Just go to this virtual, this is called as VM console, virtual box manager. We will call it also as virtual box manager. So this machine is running, right? DBA classes machine is running. Go to the settings of this machine. Go to settings. Then we have to do some network changes. Go to network. Then here we have to select bridged adapter. Go to this one. Then advanced. Here generally deny will be there. You have to select allow all. Allow all. Here you have to select bridged adapter, attach it to bridged adapter. It's a network cable which will bridge network between from my local computer, from my local laptop to virtual laptop. What generally it will do? It will create a network between from my local laptop to virtual machine. So just click on bridged adapter. Make sure that this option Broadcom 802.11 in network adapter is enabled. Then Promptious mode, if you expand this advanced feature, if you expand this advanced, you can able to see Promptious mode. Generally it will be deny mode. You have to select allow all, otherwise it will not allow you to connect remotely. Just click on OK. So now the network has been established between local machine to the virtual machine. Now just check the IP address. It has to change it to 192 series. So what is the IP address you are able to see now? IPv4 address. What is the IP address you are able to see? 192 dot. Earlier it is 10.0.2.15. Now it is 192 dot. Generally 10 series we call it as intranet series. Means that will be helpful to connect intranet only. This 192 series in network series, this IP address called the 192 series. This 192 series will call it as intranet. So you can connect to the servers remotely also. So 192.168.0.14. So the IP address also changed. Now try to connect remotely. So how you will connect remotely? Just open Windows R, then just type MSTSC. Type MSTSC, then you can able to see this pop-up. Just type 192.168.0.104. The IP address which you saw just now. 192.168.0.104. 168.0.104. So if you want to copy this IP address, how you will copy in the command prompt? Just right click on command prompt and select mark. So we cannot copy like right click and copy, right click and paste. So you have to right click and you have to select mark. Then you can able to see one cursor here, which will blinking. So select this cursor, put the cursor here. Then you can able to see now and select the text, select the number what you want to copy. Just select it, just select that part only. Then press enter. Then it is copied. So minimize this one and paste it here. Just control V. Sorry. Mark. Enter. Paste. It's not getting. Okay, no problem. Or else just type 192.168.0.104. So connect. Now it is asking administrator password. Which administrator password is asking? This is asking this administrator password. Virtual machine administrator password. This is asking not our administrator password. This is asking virtual machine administrator password. So if you are connecting a system, if you are connected to a production server remotely, means production server is a high environment. If you did anything, of course, there will be impact to the product. Maybe the product may be down. Maybe the website will be down. Everything can happen. So security will be there for production servers. Who are logged in, who are not logged in. They can able to easily track who did anything. If you did anything on the production server, it will be easily tracked. So that you can able to check who did any, if anyone did wrong things, then easily they can able to caught. So how many connections it will accept? Production server, how many connections it will accept? Means how many connections means if you are connected to the server. Just give me a minute. It is asking administrator password, means this administrator password is belongs to the virtual machine administrator password. So give the password, then click OK. Then you can able to see this type of certificate. Why I am saying all these things means if you are put 2-3 years experience, if you are connecting to the server, real-time server, if you don't know how to connect to the real-time server, that's it, you will caught on the first day itself. So don't worry if you found anything this type of settings like that. Just don't worry, just click yes. This is a certificate, that's it. So we have successfully connected to the server, production server. Treat it as a production server or server. We have successfully connected to the server successfully by using remote connection. See, in the environment, in the real time, you can able to see this type of platforms. You can able to see this type of platforms in the real time. As it is what I did now, as it is you have to do in the real time. So now you have successfully connected to the server by using RDP. So generally how many connections it will execute, how to check? So generally any server will execute in any organization, they will put maximum cap as 2 members, means only 2 persons at a time can connect to the production server. Only 2 persons at a time. How to check who are connected to the to our production server? Just open task manager, then you can able to see here users. So if anyone is connected to our server, you can able to see his name here. You can, if you are really urgent, if you are really doing important thing on the server, then you can select the user and you can disconnect. So once you have connected, if there is no connections, then it will be a problem. This means if you cannot able to disconnect now. Why? Because you are a user. You can also connect by using admin. I'll tell you later. Why? Because that will be something confused. So you can able to see how many users are connected to the production servers. By this way, you can able to see how many users are connected to the production server. So close this one. Now this the server what you are seeing is a production server, like that server. Production servers also like this, you can able to see the windows based upon the versions, OS versions they are using. So by this way we can able to create virtual remote session between your local laptop to the virtual machine. Give me a minute.